You know, he is a legend here in Middelburg.
Just last month, I was at Shul, and a leading cardiologist came up to me, Professor Eric Kluck, and he said to me, "You know, Laurie, I didn't know you came from Middelburg. Did you ever know a Dr. Max Bass?" So I said, "Of course I did. He was my doctor." And he said, "Laurie, he was the most famous diagnostician and doctor. I don't know why he stayed in Middelburg. He was famous."
Well, how long have you been working together?
Since 1962.
Yeah.
We called him one night to come and see a patient, an outpatient. And he didn't say a word, just come and say, "Hi, girls, how are you?" It was always like that. And I'm going to miss him a lot. And really, I'm going to miss him. Because if I was sick and nobody can fix me, I know that that's what I'm doing.
He's very well regarded, respected, and loved by many people. If you needed a sick note to get off work or school, you definitely didn't go to Dr. Batts. He saved a lot of people their lives and a lot of pain and suffering through making an early diagnosis of what the problem was.
Huisartskunde, or the art of general practice, required us a 2-week stint at an appropriate general practitioner. Obviously, I chose Uncle Max, and in hospitality, spent 2 weeks with Max and Sheila, and accompanied Max both at his practice and visiting outlying areas in the Middelburg area. For me, it was a privilege to view his wealth of knowledge, enthusiasm for his profession, and his care for his fellow man, irrespective of creed, color, or religion. Today, even so many years after that period, Uncle Max, the walking medical encyclopedia, but also the man, is sorely missed.
Over 69 years ago, dear Dr. Batts brought me into this world. Besides being the best doctor that my dear late parents and I have ever had, I want to mention what a special family friend Uncle Max was to me and to my dear parents. He and my dad also shared a love for the bush and spent many memorable bushveld holidays together on the Bernitz's farm. I know that his concern and dedication to his patients was to the utmost.
That night, you came and you said to Daddy, "I need to go to Joburg."
And what happened when you saw Lenny Stone go?
Galen got this letter from Dr. Batts, and he read it and he said, "It's impossible. He can't tell you what's wrong? What did he do? And I explained to him. And he said to me, what machines did he use? And I said, his stethoscope. And he said, now, what machines did he use to find out that you're in heart failure? And I said, his stethoscope. He checked me, read the letter, and he told me exactly whatever Dr. Pax has written is true. This is, and he showed me on the scanner exactly what's wrong where. And I'm absolutely crazy in love with that man anyway. I think I would have been dead.
Is a mortally wounded Herman by telling him at one of my confinements that once Max arrived, I had everything I needed, and his contribution as a father was minor. I needed Max during the confinement more than I needed Herman.
Many happy hours visiting at the Pats' house, spending time in their fabulous room that they'd built. I suppose you could call it a library, where they kept all the books that had been collected over the years, medical books, but very many wildlife books. And those were the books that kept me entertained. In fact, I once saw an advert for somebody selling a full set of African wildlife magazines, and when I asked the seller if I could purchase them, I was told that he had just sold the full set to a Dr. I. M. Patz, who lived in Middelburg.
And Dr. Patz sit down and tell you that there are no gates. He told my wife, my dear, in July, if you've got to deliver a baby at 2 o'clock at night, do you want to open the gate? No, so I removed the gate.
Not just removed, you know how many times I knocked those gates down. More than once.
So it was better to remove them.
Yes.
I know we had to have something big.
Yeah.
Because if you're going out in a hurry.
2-3 in the morning, yeah. They showed you come home, you jump in.
So we feel honored. And any time any family member wants to come and visit, Bonanga, Bonango Tati Wechuchi, La Pekuna, La Wafela Kuna, Neil Agat. Hasi Bonango for Wechuchi, La Pekuna, La Wafela Kuna. How iti yei wena, hey wena, yei wena, hey wena nawe. So fika nini lasi akona, lasi akona. How iti yei wena, hey wena, yei wena, hey wena.
Our memories of Middelburg remain and always very warm and very meaningful and very much a part of our hearts.
In his study, where the door from the driveway was always open, and I would pop in for a little bit of an advice or a discussion and land up spending a long time watching television and once more world affairs on the agenda. Also, I remembered Max. Whenever he was at the hospital, he would come down the passages whistling. Everybody would know that Max Patz, Dr. Max Patz, has arrived.
And just your dad's love of the game of cricket, sitting in the lounge, eating a banana and screaming if one of our batsmen hit a four. I remember Graham Pollock, he loved Ali Bacha. It was just very, very special.
So going to the Pats's was an all-night function, and it was a bit like saying, gentlemen, you better finish because it's time to say the morning Shema.
Also, our wonderful Pesach Seders at your long table, which stretched all the way through from the lounge dining room into Uncle Max's study, and with Uncle Max firing questions across the table to everybody. And I had to hide under the table because I was petrified
that he was going to direct these questions at me.
How Max took us to Mapoch's mine. They were going to start a mine and they were going to destroy hundreds of aloes. And we all went. I can't remember who was there, but I'm sure Julian was there and Hendrik and Laurie and Roderick. And we all climbed in the back of the car and we drove to Mapoch's mine and we helped dig out aloes. And to this day, if you come to my surgery, I have more than 300 aloes in my garden at the surgery. And Max brought a Professor Dacier, one of his colleagues, a hematologist, to the Bushveld, and all they did was catch butterflies. And I remember him catching these butterflies and being absolutely amazed at the variety of species that we have. And you know, you couldn't go to the Pat's household between 4 and 6 because Max was watching soapies. He knew the soapies, he knew the actors. And he was really lucky that these soapies were between 4 and 6 and not between 1 and 4 in the morning, because then he would have been catching babies and that would have really, really messed around with his soapies. Max Pat's, we love you. You are great. You're a tzaddik. You're a tzaddik.
Most about him is A, his ability to concentrate, absorb and recall what he was watching despite children running around his head and running around the house. When we were visiting his own children, our children, and remembered everything and was able to cut out the surrounding noise and disturbances. I could never get over them. Number one. And also secondly, his knowledge of everything under the sun. Whatever subject was raised, I raised, or somebody else raised it, he knew about it.
But he was a man of superb intellect, but particularly one not in pursuit of material objectives, but forever striving to assist suffering mankind. This was manifested so clearly in his care for and his concern with the ills that were suffered by his patients, by the needs of his family. And I say that he was the man whose intellect and pursuit of the sciences and knowledge in general was absolutely limitless. He was an inspiration to all of those who had the privilege of meeting, knowing, and being associated with Max. God bless you.
I remember when Max used to come to Germiston to pick up Sheila on a date, and he'd get involved with my father about certain subjects I never heard, but he held his own. He could put forth his ideas and his opinions that the old man was flawed. Oh, how beautifully he and Sheila used to dance. They used to glide in ballroom dancing across the floor beautifully. He once asked me to dance, only once, didn't compare.
The Pat's family went by train with two maids, Beauty and Mary, and as expected arrived in Cape Town one day later. Max, a keen bird watcher, of course, did things his way. After work, he drove by car via Welkom, collecting Joe Tucker and me for the company on the trip, the destination Cape Town. We weren't warned that we would be driving through Lesotho and I don't know where else over 4 full days, stopping for hours in the middle of nowhere, watching birds sitting on telephone poles, till eventually reaching Cape Town.
And my memories of you are as a most dignified, wonderful doctor and a very, very influential man in Middelburg, and a wonderful uncle, as well as a brilliant man with a great, great mind, very retentive and photographic memory, with incredible knowledge, particularly of birds. I will always treasure my times in Middelburg, and with you and Auntie Sheila.
zakeini ligadel bonim uvnei vonim chachomim unevoinim oi avei Hashem yirei Elokim anshei emes zera koidesh b'Hashem dveikim
הייתי בגיל, לא יודע, 9 או 10, 11, הייתי מאוד מתוסכל מכך שהבית שלנו במידלבורג לא הגיע בכלל לרמה של הבתים של היהודים האחרים. לא היינו בריכת שחייה, ולא היה לנו מגרש טניס, ולא טרמפלינה, ולא סונה, ולא wall-to-wall carpeting. אז באתי לאפמקס עם טענות חזקות מאוד, איך הוא משכן אותנו בבית כזה פושטי. אז הוא הסתכל עליי, הוא הסתכל מסביב ואומר, אבל הספרים, הוא אמר, תסתכל על הספרים. אז הבית שלנו היה רק ספרים, כל קיר היה ספרים, אפמקס אהב מאוד מאוד ספרים, שבועונים וחודשיים וכל מיני דברים, כל ספר שרץ על כל נושא היה אצלנו. ואז נפל לי הסימון והבנתי מילה אחת, ערכים. הבנתי שזה כל הסיפור, ערכים. איפה אתה שם את הדגש שלך בחיים. וזה סיפור שמלווה אותי עד היום הזה, ואני מודה מאוד מאוד אפמקס על השיעור הזאת שהוא נתן לי אז לפני המון המון שנים.
Being the youngest of six by a long shot, my dad had a very, very special place in my heart. He was for me the person that epitomized kindness, sympathy, empathy, and love of human beings, no matter who they were or what they were. He loved nature, he loved knowledge, he loved history, he loved all his children, his grandchildren and great-grandchildren with all his heart, and I miss you, Bero.
Honor and privilege of growing up with two remarkable grandparents, and we probably took for granted a little bit the time that we spent with Opa Max and Granny Sheila, but certainly the values that they instilled in us have shaped the people that we are, and I certainly am. I remember distinctly watching my bar mitzvah video from 1989, but Opa Max was interviewed at the end. Dudi, I know this is your party and I don't want to be a wet blanket. I actually had to ask what a wet blanket was at the time. But he said, the one thing I would like to tell you, and you need to remember, and the one thing that's actually stuck by me, is that you need to be a mensch no matter what. And I think that that simple message just encapsulated exactly who he was, the values that he instilled in us, how he lived his life and the legacy he leads.
Opo Max sheli, ani mitgagat el saba sheli. Shekol pam she'ra'e oti haya ba kacha, et lo neshika. Ha kol kach doeg li, ohev oti, ve'sheu ta sheli tamid tov. Tamid kacha im male male ahava.
We had an appointment with this renowned doctor from Stanford. And as he walks in the room, it was apparently was South African. And he looks at the paperwork and he asks, do you guys happen to know Dr. Max Patz? And I was completely startled. I almost fell off my chair. And I said, yes, he happens to be my grandfather. And so this young doctor is telling me that he is originally from Witbank. And that my grandfather is legendary. He never met him before, but he heard about him a lot. This was really an amazing moment where I felt extremely proud. And just shows how Opa Max, who really had an intrinsic passion, curiosity and love for anything alive, impacted his surroundings in such a memorable way.
I was a student nurse at the Gen Hospital, and we were put onto Sister Brown's ward, and we were very scared of her. I just mentioned to her that my boyfriend's husband was a doctor and he'd studied at the Gen, and she asked me his name, and I said it's Max Patz, and she heard that, and her whole attitude towards me changed. What a wonderful doctor. He was the best student, medical student, and I had no problem with Sister Brown from that minute on.
Opa Max was and will be an inspiration for me. A person that loves people, a person that loves life, a person that loves the state of Israel. We had many, 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 many discussions, and his love and his passion for the state of Israel, for the Jewish people, for the continuation of the Jewish people, was unbelievable. The way he always cared for people, and he all connected it all together. Very, very special father-in-law. Very, very special person. I miss him a lot. Love him a lot.
So what made our father, I think, what he was the fact that he was able to synthesize so well the Jewish values that he absorbed from his shtetl-like home in Brakpan, together with all the opportunities that the new world in South Africa would offer. And this resulted in the fact that our home was a Jewish home, even though we lived so far from the main Jewish centers. Chagim were Chagim, Shabbos was Shabbos. Speak to Middleburg people, they'll tell you about the wonderful Pesach Seders we had. Cheder for the Pats boys was Kaddush, we were never allowed to miss on a Tuesday and a Thursday. And together with that, he drew and he was able to excel in all the opportunities that the new world offered. He was a fantastic student. He skipped 2 years at school. He was the youngest graduate of medical school. It drew him into the love of Africa and the natural life. And he synthesized these two so well. And this is what made him what he was. And this is what he passed on to us and what we hopefully have been passed on to our children. The other aspect, which I have no explanation for, was that he had this passion to help people, to take care of people. He was never driven by making money, and he never made money. His was a service for the people, which he did so well, which made him a legend, not only in that little town of Middleburg that he dedicated his life to, but in the entire South Africa. And I think this summarizes what our father really was.